369, bringing in the sheaves. 369.
Oh, we're together. We
question is, how shall we stand up on that day? Our Sabbath school lesson, Brother Carlos mentioned something about standing before the great God Almighty, all alone. And the question is, how shall we stand on that day? 530. 530. It is well with my soul.
Thank you. Almighty God, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Ghost. This morning, we are grateful and we are honored to be in your presence. We reflect back this past month of April, and there's so many things that you have done for all of us, individually and collectively as your children. We thank you for life. We thank you for everything you have done to sustain us during the pandemic. And this morning we are here to worship you, and we would like to invite your presence. We humbly ask that you please draw near, be with us, and bless us by accepting our worship. We thank you so much for your love, your grace, and your mercy. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Please be seated. I'm going to invite my wife, Ms. Rhea, to come up. I'd like to introduce her to you unofficially until she is baptized. Sharia and I have met a while back when I was stranded in Samoa. She was not a Seventh-day Adventist. So after we met, she found out that I am a minister. And she was scared. But I believe, and I told her that I believe that if it is God's will, that we will be together. So all the time that I was in Samoa, and then also after I returned, we had communicated and studied a lot about the doctrines that we have, that we believe. And every single subject that we believe and we studied, I asked her a question. If she understands, or if she has any questions. So as a format for any new baptized members into the Seventh-day Adventist, I have to read to her the questions and she will answer. So, Ms. Surya Payu, you can respond yes, I do, or no. I believe there is one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, a unity of three co-eternal persons. Do you hear her? Okay, I want to make sure. Do you accept the death of Jesus Christ on Calvary as the atoning sacrifice for your sins and believe that through faith in his shed blood, you are saved from sin and its penalty?
Yes, I do.
You renounce the world and its sinful ways and have accepted Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, believing that God, for Christ's sake, has forgiven your sins and given you a new heart.
Yes, thank you.
That you accept by faith the righteousness of Christ by intercessors in a heavenly sanctuary, and accept his promise of transforming grace and power to live a loving, Christ-centered life in your home and before the world.
Yes, thank you.
Amen.
That you believe that the Bible is God's inspired word, the only rule of faith and practice for the Christian. You covenant to spend time regularly in prayer and Bible study.
Yes, I do.
That you accept the Ten Commandments as a transcript of the character of God and a revelation of His will. Is it your purpose, by the power of the indwelling Christ, to keep this law, and including the fourth commandment, which requires the observance of the seventh day of the week as the Sabbath of the Lord and the memorial of the creation?
Yes, thank you.
That you look forward to the soon coming of Jesus and the blessed hope when this mortal shall put on immortality. As you prepare to meet the Lord, you will witness to his loving salvation, and by life, word, and your manners of living, to be ready for his glorious appearing. And that you accept the biblical teaching of spiritual gifts and believe that the gift of prophecy is one of the identifying marks of the remnant church.
Yes.
That you believe in church organization. And is it your purpose to support the church by tithes and offerings and by personal effort and influence?
Yes, thank you.
That you believe that your body is the temple of the Holy Spirit and will honor God by caring for it, avoiding the use of that which is harmful, abstaining from all unclean foods, from the use and manufacture of or sale of alcoholic beverages, the use and manufacture or sale of tobacco in any of its forms for human consumption, and from the misuse or of trafficking in narcotics or other drugs.
Yes.
That you know and understand the fundamental Bible principles as taught by the Seventh-day Adventist Church, and that you purpose, by the grace of God, to fulfill His will by ordering your life in harmony with these principles.
Yes, I do.
That you accept the New Testament teaching of baptism by immersion and desire to be so baptized as a public expression of faith in Christ and His forgiveness of your sins.
Yes, I do.
Last but not least, that you accept and believe that the Seventh-day Adventist is the remnant church of Bible prophecy And that people of every nation, race, and language are invited and accepted into its fellowship. That you desire to be a member of this local congregation of the Emmanuel Seventh-day Adventist Church and also the World Church.
Yes, I do.
You heard her testimony. We will now prepare for baptism. She will come that way, and I can, and as we continue on.
Let us stand together and sing 258, baptize us by you.
Thank you. know, when I was preparing my wife for baptism, I was reminded of several people in our church that have not yet gone through baptism. And so this morning, I'm sure the Holy Spirit is calling you. I'm sure you have been waiting for so long that you have been fighting to pull off the call. And so before I come up, I want to give you a chance. If you have a desire to be baptized, not today if you're not ready, maybe next Sabbath, maybe sooner. Of course, life is not guaranteed to you for the next day. The Holy Spirit is speaking to your heart. If you decide to be baptized sooner, talk to me afterwards. I would be glad to go through the doctrine of the church, the teaching of Jesus Christ, and prepare you for baptism before it's too long. May God bless us all this morning. Heavenly Father, we thank you for another soul that is won to your kingdom. We thank you for calling her and accepting her into your kingdom. And as she is added to the roll call of heavens to come. It is my prayer this morning, Lord, that you please continue to impress upon the hearts of those that are willing to follow your lead and those that would like to enter into the kingdom of heaven when you come again, dear Jesus. Bless us as we continue our worship this morning. In Jesus, our loving Savior's name, we pray. Amen.
Wonderful day it is to have another soul won into the kingdom.
Yes.
And as Pastor had mentioned earlier, or while he was speaking, if you have not been baptized, would like to be baptized, please approach him or one of the elders and let them know so that we can get you on your way. Scripture tells us that you should repent and be baptized. It is our desire, and it is in our hearts that every one of you will be saved in the kingdom. Scripture also tells us that no man knows the day or the hour. So before that day or hour comes for you, make sure that you are saved in the kingdom. This morning our announcements are as follows. As Brother Al always alludes to, please turn off your cell phone. I'm going to say that again. Please turn off your cell phone. Okay, you're all looking at me, and I got it, right? But when you decide not to do that, and the main service starts when the pastor's speaking, your cell phone will go off. Even though everyone you know and love knows you're at church, they will still call and try to text you. So please, we ask that you silence or turn off your cell phone. Remember to maintain your distance. I know, you know, as we start to get back to normal and we start to fill up, that'll be a little bit of a challenge, but we ask that you do that. And if you're not standing in the podium and speaking directly into the microphone, we ask that you keep your mask above your nose and your mouth, okay? This month, breakfast at the church, I believe this morning was our first breakfast.
Amen.
And I'm sure that that was a wonderful breakfast and opportunity for those that wanted to get to church early. Pastor George and his new wife will be confirmed and dedicated tomorrow here at 3 p.m. They ask, and we ask, that you please join them here. A big thank you and appreciation to the gentleman that came and took care of the grounds. Two Sundays ago, thank you so much for that. I don't think you need to mention their names, but thank you so much, gentlemen, for your efforts to keeping our church presentable, not only to the community, but to God. Next Sunday is Mother's Day. By a show of hands, who has forgotten their mother? Who has not gotten them a gift already or has a plan? Let's make sure that we do that. All right? Let's remember the mothers. And if they are not mothers, but ladies of our church, let's remember them anyway, because I'm sure that they have a part in taking care of our little ones. Our church board meeting for the month of May is postponed due to Mother's Day. All right, so May 16th, we'll take care of the church board meeting. Please put that on your calendars. Health and Ministries Community Service Department are requesting toothbrushes that they be soft, not medium or hard. Toothpaste, soap, wet wipes. We're trying to make at least 500 kits to give out to the migrants that are here. I know there are a lot of people that may feel that they don't deserve to be here, but they are God's children, and they are here.
Amen.
And we will do what we can. And if you don't have a specific ministry, your giving is your ministry.
Amen.
So we would ask that you give, if you can, bring those items. Sister Carmen has put a tub outside by the door. I believe it's pink. You can bring those items and drop them off so we can get those kits made.
Right.
We have an open door policy here, open door and phone cell phone call communication. If you look at your bulletin, the pastor's number is in there. Also, my number as the first elder, my number is in there. You can call me whenever you want. You can call the pastor whenever you need to. If it's for prayer, if you need food, if you need any kind of assistance, do not hesitate to call the pastor or one of the elders. That's what we're here for. Okay? We don't want to see any of our members or our guests go without. So please keep your program so that you have my number and you have the pastor's number. Really quickly before I sit down, I'd like to thank all of our guests for coming. Thank you so much for being here. We want you to know that you are always welcome, and on your third visit, you are a member. So, if this is your first time, you've got two more visits, and we hope to see you again next Saturday.
Amen.
If you're looking for a home church, we pray that you find this church to be a happy and comfortable, loving church.
Amen.
Thank you.
Morning. Our responsive reading is in hymnal 759. Jesus answered, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God.
By one Spirit, we were all baptized into one body in Jews and Greeks, slaves and free, and all were made of one Spirit.
Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death?
We were buried, therefore, with him by God's living to them. So that the Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, we serve my love.
For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we shall surely be united with him in a resurrection like his.
We know that our old self is crucified with him, so that the sinful body might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For he has died, is freed from sin.
Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you.
And go with you to the close of the age.
Great. May the Lord bless this whisper.
Amen. Amen.
Good morning, happy Sabbath.
Good morning, happy Sabbath.
We're so glad that you all are here. Isn't it wonderful to come to the Lord? Yes. Hearing the rain come down to water our garden that we put out back, as well as our gardens we may have at home and in any other areas that are desperately needed water. We have time for our prayer. I'm sure a lot of you have silent prayer requests as well as personal prayers. We'll show by the raising of the hands those who have a silent prayer request. And I want to remember Brother Pete, who is still recovering from his injury, as well as Sister Meredith and her husband, Brother William. They are not able to be here at this time, so let's remember them in our prayers throughout the week. Let's also remember those of us who are going through trying times right now, whether it's something good that you're having to do, something not so good maybe that you still have to deal with and work through. We just pray that the Lord will bless you and help you through the situation. And we want to be so thankful. I'm so thankful that we all come here today. But there's a time coming. The Word of God says there's a time coming that's going to be a time of trouble such as never has been so before. We need to pray that we will all be ready when that time comes and be able to stand up for what's right, to stand for what God wants us to stand for, and not follow the things of the world that are going to lead us down the wrong path. So let's take all these things to prayer. Shall we kneel on our seats? Yeah. reach out and touch every one of our phones. Let's not provide any of them. Just be sure that you are open to the Lord. We are family representatives, those who are living, who are alive, who are away, that you be with them, bless them, and protect them, bring them healing. Remember these are the things that you are doing. Just continue to keep us in the place we are. Help us to remember that it is you who gives us life each and every day, it is you who works through us. And I'm praying to have us already know that you're coming back and that we can share with others to help them to be ready as you're coming so soon. Help us to stand apart in the world. Help us to recall the word as we study and we need to be witness to others to help them and lead them to the word of God. We thank you for hearing our prayer. We thank you for the many answered prayers you can make. We pray all these things in Jesus' name.
The church met for a business meeting to discuss the idea. The pastor listed the costs of the meetings, airfare, car rental, motel, meals, and so on. One family said, "We don't have extra money, but we do have a nice guest room. We can invite the evangelist to our home. That will save the cost of a motel. We can also eat breakfast with us each day." Another family said, "We can provide evening meals." A third family offered, "We can use our pickup." In the back of the room, three families whispered amongst themselves, "We can pay for the airline ticket." They announced. Within a short time, plans were complete. The evangelist came, and the church plant rejoiced to see the fruits of their giving. When a church comes together, what seems impossible can become possible. Each family gave what they had. As a result, the Lord's work went forward. Every man shall give as he is able, according to the blessing of the Lord thy God, which he had given thee. Deuteronomy 16:17. Today, let's come together and live as our wonderful God has blessed us. Let's consider this as the beginning of the Lord.
Thank you.
Let's all stand, please.
So that we will have the means to spread your goodness, your love, your hope every day to everyone we meet and those that we cannot meet directly, but through some other means, even so long as they hear the praise that you do. We pray that you will continue to bless us, to bless those who can't give now, and also those who give. We pray that you will continue to to do your will so that the day becomes peace. The same in your Son Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. You may be seated.
Our children's story this morning will be brought to us by an orphan.
Thank you.
morning, boys and girls. And I tell them finally this morning, thank God, God is woken you up this morning, that you don't feel sick or anything. Isn't that good?
Amen.
All right. Okay, now raise your hand if you know what a missionary is. Any of you know what a missionary is? Can you tell me, what is a missionary? Oh no, that's a mission. It's not a missionary. Okay, it's okay. I made mistakes too. I didn't hear that right the first time I heard that. It's all right. Now, what a missionary is, it's easy. Missionary is a person who travels around your city, around the country, around the world to tell others about Jesus. That's right, a missionary. A person who travels to tell others about Jesus, about how good he is, and the good stuff he's done, and the good stuff he's going to do. Well, the story I'm going to tell you about a young missionary who's doing some missionary work in Central Africa. Now, one morning, he was preparing to get out to do his missionary work. He prayed that morning, and he prayed saying, God, please guide me today, protect me, help me to do what I need to do for you. Let me be an example of your goodness to others I meet. And Lord, I pray you will be with me always. Amen. That's the first thing he did. That's one good thing you can do every morning. First thing you do in the morning, get up and pray. Thank God also for getting you up, that you're not hurt, that you're not dead. You're alive and well. Now, the missionary prayed.
Yeah.
Okay. The missionary prayed and went off to do his missionary work. And as he was walking the dusty road, he was wiping sweat off his forehead. It was really hot. Have any of you ever been to Central Africa? Oh, you live there. Okay. Well, then you know it's pretty hot there, right? Especially in the summer. He was wiping with perspiration, saying, ugh, it's so hot. Wish I could find a water hole nearby. And in that region in Central Africa, sometimes there would be occasional passing storms and rains that would leave big bodies of water, like ponds or stuff. He's watching the dusty road, still wiping, thinking about finding a water hole, and he happens to see this beautiful big pond somewhere a little bit far off the road. Ooh, perfect! A perfect, gleaming, glowing, sparkling, beautiful pond. This is my lucky break. He went off into the road. I can hear it. He looked around. There's no one around. I can so use a good big dip in the water right now. So, he began to take off his clothes. And suddenly, he heard a voice. Don't go in. He looked around. See, who said that? He didn't see anyone. There's no one there. That's strange. I wonder if this heat is making me hear things. So he continued to move on his clothes, began to take off his shoes, and then he heard the voice again. Don't go in! He looked it down again. And he didn't see anyone. And he thought, ugh, I better hop in that pond water right now before this heat makes me go crazy. He began to walk near the water's edge and suddenly hear the voice. And it sounded like this. Don't go in! It's louder than before, that voice here. This time it sounded very serious. Something serious. And he thought, pray to God to get stuck on the light. I wonder if God is trying to warn me something. So he didn't go into the cool waters like he was planning to do, no. Instead, he began to walk around the pond water curiously and cautiously. He didn't see anything odd about the water. And then he went back in towards the tree and he sat down for a moment. It's like sparkling water. I can't see what's wrong here. And then suddenly, the water rippled. Two small orbs came about it. He suddenly realized what this is.
Those with your eyes, what do you call this creature? A crocodile. It was the eyes of a crocodile. And his name was... Does anyone want to give this crocodile a name?
Gator.
What do you want to call it? You want to call it alligator? do you want to name the alligator? Who wants to name the crocodile here? Okay, what do you want to call it? Opsy? Opsy. Okay. So suddenly, the eyes of Opsy suddenly watched out and watched cheerily at the missionary. Suddenly, the missionary realized what they were. He knows what it meant. God was warning him. If he had so much, put a toe into that pond water, he would have died violently. Not a pretty picture, right? So, he walked off from a good distance from the pond water. He said, God, thank you. Thank you for so much for saving my life. Thank you for giving me protection. Thank you for protecting me from Popsy. Thank you for giving me something to tell others about your goodness. Amen. So, the eyes of Popsy. Did I get his name right? Popsy. The eyes of Popsy watched him dress up, and the missionary went away. Now, what I want you to learn from this story is, first of all, it's like the first commandment. Put God in your life, first in your life. Pray every morning when you wake up, ask him for his protection, his guidance, and thank him also for his goodness and his love. Also, second, when you hear something telling you to do something or to not to do something, it's the Holy Spirit talking to you. So, why are you like listening? And also, always remember, God will be with you every day.
Amen.
You can go back to your seats now.
Worshiping music this morning come to us by our brother Al and sister Diego. Following the special music, the next voice you will hear will be that of our pastor George Brown. Thank you.
was wounded and wasted. And your soul was bound up, oh heaven.
Thank you, Brother El, and your lovely wife for such a blessing. Special music. There is a river that will never run dry. That's one of my favorite that Brother Henry always sings sometimes. Yes, there is a river that will never, never run dry. I'd like to take this moment to welcome each and every one of our regular members. I know I have been skipping the last two Sabbaths so that I can be quarantined with my new wife. That's why I was not here, to be safe. But I'd like to take this moment to again welcome each and every one of our regular members. I was counting how many we are missing today. We are missing 20 people. So I believe if they were all here, we will have a full house. So pray for them. Some of them are still recovering from the virus and also from other sickness. I would like to welcome some of the new people. I'm sure some of you have forgotten Brother Alvin and his lovely wife. Alvin, stand for a minute, please. Yeah, I was hoping to get you before the baptism, but we're working that. And we are happy that your wife has returned safely from Puerto Rico. Bring the warm weather. So, welcome back. Look forward to working with you soon. Those are new members of our church. Then we also have my daughter here from Sherman. I know many of you haven't seen her, but she decided to move away from me. That's my youngest daughter, Edna. Edna, you understand? And no, she's shy. All right, so Edna is here. And I was told that we were supposed to have Ed and Sherry. Are they here?
Shirley's here.
Oh, Shirley.
Yes.
Okay. All right. We're happy that you accepted the call and invitation and joined us today. We hope that you will continue to come.
Thank you.
Amen. Okay. And then, how many of you have been to the restroom? How does it look?
Great.
Amen. Well, we invited the carpenter and his lovely wife, Gerald and Rose. Do you want to stand for a minute? We are working into getting them to the church.
Amen.
Because we need a permanent carpenter, don't we?
Yeah.
All right. We welcome you. Now, I noticed there is another couple in front of it. Well, I haven't got a card on you. Would you mind? Yes, you. You're looking at each other. Can I have your name?
Sure. It's Ralph and Sylvia.
Ralph and Sylvia.
Yes.
Are you from San Antonio?
We just moved here.
You just moved here. Amen.
Welcome.
What do you say?
Welcome.
Welcome. Ralph and Sylvia. I'm so happy to have you today. We haven't opened for fellowship lunch yet, but we're hoping that will be soon. Because we hate having visitors and then go home and not inviting them to lunch. So we're working on that. But we hope that you will come back and visit some more, and we hope that you will choose to join our church this morning. Now, before I start, I want to also welcome my dear wife, lovely wife, Surya, and her daughter, which is my daughter now, my youngest daughter. It's unusual to say youngest daughter. All right, Mary, you want to stand for a minute? Surya and Mary, stand for a minute. Now, face around so that they can see you. That's the new addition to my family and also the new addition to our church.
Amen.
We are slowly growing, isn't it?
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Yes.
Yeah. So at this time, I would like to invite Miss Surya to come up. And I would like the elders to come up, please. Okay, as a custom and tradition, we always prepare a little welcome token for the baptism. Baptismal individuals. So at this time, you will stand here. And this is your certificate of baptism. And this is a little something from the church to welcome you. And we would like to welcome you to our church.
Don't worry about it.
I was praying for a message this morning, asking the Lord to give me a message that will suit for our members, our young people, and for our visitors this morning. Allison, well, you're no longer, I did not forget about you, and Dorothy, yeah, I haven't forgotten about you, but you are a member of our church already. So we are glad that you are here this morning. And so I was thinking that tomorrow is my wedding or marriage dedication or blessing. We have already been officialized at the city, the courthouse 2 weeks ago, but tomorrow it is something that we pastors and ministers have to go through. It's just like an ordination, but this time it's just a dedication and also a blessing of our marriage before we set out to serve the Lord. And so I was thinking, what could I speak about today that will suit for everybody? Not only adults, our regular members, our visitors, but also the children. And a thought came to mind that what about a new beginning? A new beginning, we have just begun a new month today. We just started May. It's a new beginning, a new month. And I want to go back, way, way back to the creation when God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit had come together to create earth and the world. And as I was reading, I found that it was not God's, the purpose of the divine Godhead or Trinity to have new beginnings and new beginnings and new beginnings. That when they created heaven and earth at the very beginning, it was a new beginning, and it was the purpose that everything will continue on and on and on without a break. But that did not continue. When Adam and Eve had failed God, the bond broke. So for them to restart again, they had to do a new beginning. They had to go through the process of having a new beginning, reintroducing themselves to God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. And so as I thought about this, the life that we are living, somehow, when things ended, we start with a new beginning. No matter what it is. A new year, a new month, a new marriage, a new relationship, a new friendship, a new job, and so forth. It becomes a routine in life that everything has a new beginning. When my late wife passed away 2 years ago, almost, a thought came to me, that's it for me, that I have lost someone that was my helper, that I have lost someone that we were together for 49 years. So I never looked forward to a new beginning. To me, that was it. My wife is gone, life is over. I don't know if I'm going to be able to live for 5 or 7 more years. But as I thought about that, and as I traveled away from the United States to Australia, New Zealand, Samoa, and Hawaii, you know, a thought came to me, no, life continues on. And I was thinking of those people that have anxiety, that have become so sick and gave up. And so the Lord has inspired me that there is life after today. And that's how I began to look for another helper. So I found a helper. We looked at each other. She looked at me. I looked at her. And I said, Lord, is this it? You have to make me fall in love again. I just don't want to go through the motion. I want to go back to the very first time when I fell in love with Sally, and I want to re-experience that. It's called a new beginning. And so here we are. The only thing that stood in my way, in our ways, was being a non-Adventist person. As we all know, we as ministers are not allowed to marry non-believers and believers. So I called the pastor, I called the one that being my counselor, and asked him, what does he think? And he said, she has to be baptized. Otherwise, that new beginning will not take place. So we worked on it for several months. We studied. I want to make sure she understands what we believe, and she accepted it, and then we formed a relationship. A friendship. And God has blessed us to unite here in the United States. If you have your Bible, Henry, if you can, please put that responsive reading on the... So our sermon today comes from the book of 1 Corinthians 12, Romans 6, Matthew 28, and John 3. They were all put together for this reading today. So if you can take a look at what you read as a responsive reading. Number 759 in the back of your hymnal. And it's entitled Baptism, a New Beginning. It's when a new person or a person came to know Christ, decided to study more about the life of Christ, and accepted Christ's principles of life, spiritual principle, and then follow through with baptism. And I looked at this reading and I said, you know, this is not fair for the visitors. Because if you look at it, it's right there on the, it says, Jesus answered, truly, truly, I I say to you, unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God. Is the Lord trying to tell us something? Dear Lord and loving kind Heavenly Father, we are opening your word now. We would like to receive the message, Heavenly Father. And we ask that you please inspire me and open our hearts, our minds. Speak through me that we will be blessed today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Truly, truly, I say to you, unless you are born of water and the Spirit, you cannot enter into the kingdom of God. Why did Jesus do this? It sounds like it's a stipulation. It sounds like that it's a requirement that in order for us to enter heaven, we must go through baptism and have a new beginning. These are some strong words from Jesus. Unless one is born of water and the Spirit, he cannot enter of God. I am thankful that God and that Jesus Christ has made it clear for us. Plain and simple. You want to follow me? Be baptized. You want to follow me? Follow my lead. Every single thing that Jesus was not supposed to do, he did it. He did all of them just to give us examples so that we can follow through. You know, when I was doing that, I was reminded of someone in the Bible that is very well known. I don't know how many of you brought your Bible, but if you did, turn with me. Someone that knows everything about life, someone that knows everything about good and bad, and he was the one that was supposed to influence for many people. And downgraded. Or criticize it, so to speak. I'm reading from King James. The words of a preacher, the son of David, king in Jerusalem, which is Solomon. Vanity of vanities, said the preacher. Vanity of vanities, all is vanity. The word vanity meaning is a waste. It's no good. What profit hath a man of all his labor which he taketh under the sun? Verse 4, one generation passeth away, another generation cometh, but the earth abideth forever. As I read, think about it. The sun also ariseth, and the sun goeth down, and hasteth to his place where he arose. The wind goeth off the south towards the south, and turneth about unto the north. It whirleth about continually, and the wind returneth again according to his circuits. Number 7. All the rivers run into the sea, yet the sea is not full unto the place from whence the rivers come. Either they return again. All things are full of labor. It sounds like he was complaining or criticizing. Man cannot utter it or understand it. The eye is not satisfied with seeing, nor the ear filled with hearing. And I like the verse 9. Verse 9, it says, the thing that hath been, it is that which shall be. And that which is done is that which shall be done. And there is no new thing under the sun. No new thing under the sun. Then he asked the question there. Is there anything whereof it may be said, see, this is new? It had been already of old time, which was before us. As you read and restudy it, you can understand it seems like Solomon was frustrated. Somehow in his life, he had hit the wall. There was frustration. There were things that he experienced that didn't go right. And so I ask a question this morning for you and for me. Have you ever relooked at your life day to day? And look at how God has led you from the past, and how He direct and help and bless us from day to day. So every day to me, every day when you wake up in the morning, it's a new day, it's a new beginning. It is. And we are to appreciate it, not so much as Solomon did, but we are to thank God for life. We are to thank God for every blessing that he has given to us. No matter what it is. Sometimes we do not appreciate things that we do not agree with, because it becomes a hindrance in our life. But if we know and understand the purpose of Jesus Christ and his ministry is to prepare us for a new beginning, a new life in heaven. Second Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17, Paul says, 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17. Therefore, If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are passed away. Behold, all things are become new. We don't look at the negatives. We don't look at the bad things. We look at the blessing that comes with it. It was a pleasure this morning to baptize my wife. And when I was on the island, I heard a song that was impressive to me. And I had asked her, have you ever sang that song before? And she said, yes, I have. So I'm going to ask her to come. Sing that song. In the word of that song, a question is asked. An appeal is made to give your life, to give my life, to give our lives as a new beginning every day in our relationship with Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Renew it. Make it new. Day in and day out. Instead of us focusing on the negative, on the hurt, let's focus on what the blessing that comes with it. So I'm going to ask her to come.
Thank you.
I think she's scared. The words of that song really touched me. Lord, I see a world that is dying, wounded by the master of deceit, groping in the darkness, haunted by the years of past. But then I see you standing near me, Lord, shining with compassion in your eyes. Daily stars shine down on me. Let that's what a new beginning is. You are put to where you are. You live where you live because God put you there. If you have never thought about it, where you live is where God sent you to live, for the purpose of shining in the dark. There is a dark world out there. You and I are considered the light and the beam of the light to the world. Jesus is coming soon. We must see to it that our neighbors, our co-workers, our friends heard about the coming of Jesus Christ. Not so much about the Sabbath keeping, but about Jesus and his love. Lead them. Show them. Let them know that Jesus is coming and coming very soon. That's a new beginning. That's a new life. Beginning tomorrow, beginning today. Let shine through and let Jesus live within us. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this special Sabbath. We thank you for reminding us again, no matter what we go through in our lives, ups and downs, you was faithful as you promised to be with us. We thank you, Lord, for leading me to win another soul to you. Not only her, but her family. Not only her family, but the friends. Let her life now be beginning to shine as a new beginning to all those that knew her or that knows her, that she will now be a witness for you, dear Lord. May each and every one of us do the same as we continue through this year of the pandemic. A new month just begin. May our lives continue to shine and lead others to thy second coming, dear Lord. Be with us as we continue in this world and in this life. It's our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let's stand and sing our closing hymn. Because he lives, I can face tomorrow.
Here's to the flower.
Okay.
Just a reminder for tomorrow, 3 p.m. here for the dedication ceremony for the pastor. Let's not forget that. It's going to be a high time tomorrow. Also, I would be remiss if I did not remind you that if you have not been baptized, if you have not given your life to Jesus, please, please, please do not let another day pass. If that is on your heart, please contact the pastor or myself, Elder Al, and we will get that started for you, because it is our desire to see you all saved in the kingdom. And that is what we want for you and for all your love. Let's pray. Father, as we leave this place, Lord God, we take you with us in our hearts.
Amen.
Lord, for all those that have not been baptized, that witnessed today, Lord God, we ask that you would touch their hearts.
Yes.
Amen. That you would send your spirit to commune with them and continue to work on their heart.
Amen.
That when you're coming, that on that bright morning, Lord God, they will be caught up in the clouds with all of us.
Amen.
Lord, Scripture says that it is your desire that none be lost.
Yes.
So let us continue to work towards that goal.
Amen.
And as we leave this place today, Lord God, but never from your presence, we ask that you continue to watch over us, keep
Amen.
Us, and protect us. That is our prayer in Jesus' name.
Amen. Amen.